Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you how we can perform WGCNA analysis using R. And I will be using two files. So this first file is actually the gene expression file, which I have saved in the form of text. And here I have this clinical data, which is actually the phenotypic data of these samples. So let me show you my first file, which is this gene expression file. So you can also organize your data in the form of this. So as here you can see, the first column is actually the gene names, and then these all rows have different sample or different treatments. So you can also integrate your data for all genes into one file, and then you can export it in the form of TXT so that it would be easy to follow the R script which I have designed. And I will be uploading this R script to my GitHub page. So as here you can see, this link I will be pasting in the video description, and you can go to this link. And as here you can see, I have also pasted this R script which I have just opened here. And this R script is special because, I mean, compared to others, this R script is like relatively smaller, and I mean, and there are less errors. You don't need to go through like the long R script for performing WGCNA analysis. And then I have also uploaded this clinical data, which is actually the traits data. Let me open it for you as well. So here you see we have the different sample names, which were like just in the row wise in the previous file, I mean the gene expression file. Then we have the different stages, and as here you can see, we have just assigned like 1 and 0 as to quantify. I mean, if it is there, so we will mention 1. If it is not there, so it means this is 0. So this is the clinical data, and we will be performing WGCNA analysis using my simple R script. So let's go to R Studio and let's start. So the prerequisite for this is to install the WGCNA package. And if you want to go for functional enrichment and other functional annotation and pre-processing packages, so you need to install these packages, among which is the bioconductor. And then we also need the scatter plot 3D package. But usually if you will install the WGCNA package, so I believe it would be enough. So let me test my WGCNA package if it is there. So you see it is already there, although it is giving few errors, but maybe we can ignore this. And let me just load. Yeah, you see it is working. So now the next step is to set the working directory. So let me open this folder, because all the follow-up files will be downloaded and saved in this folder. So we can go to this three dots. So we can click on here, and let me go to my this folder, which I have WGCNA and example number 3. So I am going to open this one. So as here you can see, I have asked to set it as a working directory. So how we can set it as a working directory? We can simply click on this dot, and we can write set as working directory. So you can see it has automatically wrote the code, and now our working directory is this folder. So now let's formally begin. And as here you can see, I have also added line by line details of the code, I mean why we are doing this. Although I will be running the code as a whole, like in the chunks, like this is the first part. First part involves the loading of expression of data into the file. Then we will be selecting soft threshold, and then we will be constructing the urgency matrix. Then we will be going for medule detection, and then we will be topological overlay matrix, and then we will be going for multi-dimensional scaling plot, and then we will be drawing 3D scatter plot, and then we will be going for module eigengene analysis. So I will be introducing all these terms meanwhile the analysis, and then we will be going for module correlation plot, and the lastly we will be exporting our module for module membership. Then we will export this for Cytoscape if needed. And we have then how to relate with the clinical traits, but maybe we don't need in for this present example. Then we will be performing heat module trait correlationship, and then we will, yeah, that's it. So now let's formally begin and go with our first file by loading the expression. So as here you can see, our data is actually the input data one. I mean, we will name this TCGA text file, which I have just previously shown. And let me run this code as a whole. So you see here, we have now two data sets. The first one you see here, we have the gene list and we have their sample or the treatment's name. So we have saved this in the form of data zero, and we have data expression, which is actually the large matrix. So this is that one. So you see, actually we have removed the sample names for just WGCNA purpose. And now we will be going for important step, which is the choosing of soft threshold for our data. And meanwhile, our files will be saved here. So we will be keep refreshing this if there is anything new generated in the form of PDF or not. So, okay, I will be going for soft threshold. And as we know, soft threshold is important for scale-free topology network approximation. And usually we select it, I mean, greater than 0.85. So let me run it. Okay, maybe we can run it as a whole. And this is like, okay, so you see here we have now our additional data. You can see we have R square values for these 15. I mean, when the R square is 1 to 20, we have value, and we will be selecting around, I mean, when the means is closer to 0 and the power would be around like the 8 to 12 usually in most of the analysis. So, and we will be constructing our graphs as well to get a better idea. So as here you can see, we have also generated one beta PDF in the analysis. So let me show you this one. So you see in the first one, we have scale free topology module fit. So you can see 1, 2, 3, and 4, and you see when the R square is point more than 3 or 4, so it has approached to 0.8. So, and this is now mean connectivity, and you can see we should take care, I mean, it should has not dropped to the zero, but I mean close to between 5 would be okay. So we will select just auto fit model, and now we will be using this as beta 16 to construct the urgency matrix, and we will be choosing soft threshold based on this plot. And you can see the connectivity and this soft connectivity. We will be computing, and then we will be saving the scale free topology plot to the PDF. So let me run it as a whole. Okay, yeah, this one. So let me check if anything is new generated. So you see here we have actually TC scale free PDF. This is just newly added. So you see this is the like the soft threshold power and urgency matrix. And then now we will be going for module detection. So we will be using just, like filter to the top. We can change this number according to our need. Then we will be ranking the genes for connectivity. Then we will be creating subset, then computing urgency matrix and topological overlay, topological overlap matrix distance, and then we will be going for hierarchical clustering of TOM. Then we will be assigning module colors, but this is all just theoretical details. So we will simply select this whole code and run it. So you see here, now we have different connectivity values. And you see here, anything is not added yet new. And then we will be going for TOM plot this. So we will save it in the form of TOM. So you see here, now we have topological overlap matrix. So we can use this, and then we will have multi-dimensional scaling plot. Let me save it by running the code. And we have CMD. You see here we have MDS plot for all the variables. And then we will be using 3D scatter plot. Let me load that package first. That is this code library. And we can simply go to the run. And you see here we have 3D PDF. So it is giving us the scaling in 3D axis, axis 1, axis 2, and axis 3. And now we can go for module eigengene analysis. And we will be using these files, which were, automatically created during the analysis. So let me run it. It's there. So maybe we can go ahead and can create module correlation plot for pairwise scatter plot of module eigengenes. And we know that my eigengenes are actually the representative from the different module, and they are usually based on the first principal component. And okay, let me see. You see here we have module cluster. Here you see we have on the basis of height, then we have clustering tree based on the module eigengene. And here we have module for all. And then let me run it correlation matrix and write the table. So then we will be exporting the gene module membership. So we can simply select, we can select all this. And if you want to go into the detail, why we are running this code, so you can pause the video and take a look, why we are doing this. And then we are exporting our network to the cytoscape. So you see all the downstream analysis is automatically saved. So this script is fully reproducible on any data. You just need to rename your data and you can run this, and with just minor changes, whatever you want, how many, like number of genes you want to select. And then we have export for the cytoscape. You see here we have the genes for exporting for cytoscape. Then we need to relate it, but if we need to make the module correlation, so we also need to relate this. So you see here we have the module clinical in the form of Excel. We have also the p-values, and we have also the correlation values. And if we want heat map of module to trait relationship, we can run this simple code again. So you see here we have test matrix v1, v2, v3, okay. And we can go with PDF, and we can choose run. Okay, so here we have module. You can see that we have the module trait relationship. So in this way, now we can go to this folder and check our whole data. You see here, this is all the data which is required for WGCNA analysis. So hopefully this R script would be fully reproducible for your data as well. But if you have any question, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.